Antarctica is connected to the climate in an interesting way. As the planet warms, the winds around Antarctica become stronger, and that pumps warm ocean water up against the margin of the ice sheet. So what we're trying to do is understand what happens when the ocean starts to melt the margins. But we're doing that by studying the interior of the glacier. You can think about it like uncorking the bottle. As the ocean melts the ice at the margins, the ice in the interior starts to speed up, flow out to the ocean, and melt. So to make predictions about Thwaites Glacier's future, we need to understand both the forcing, what the ocean is doing at the margins, and the response, what the glacier is doing in the interior. My name is Nick Holschuh. I'm an assistant professor of geology at Amherst College, and I'm here in West Antarctica studying Thwaites Glacier. We are here as part of the International Thwaites Glacier Collaboration. It's a partnership between the US and the UK to study one of Earth's largest, most rapidly changing, most vulnerable glacier systems. The ITGC program involves scientists who are studying the ocean, who are studying the atmosphere, who are modeling the glaciers, who are studying the history of Thwaites Glacier and its future, all to try and make better predictions about how much and how fast sea level might rise over the next century as a result of deglaciation of Thwaites. We're sleeping in tents most of the time. Here on the Traverse, we have big Weatherhaven tents that accommodate 4 people. But elsewhere, as part of our team, we have folks sleeping in little pyramid tents that are really resilient for the cold and the high winds that we experience here in Antarctica. We're cooking and cleaning for ourselves, but we have mechanics and heavy machinery operators that are helping support our project too. We are using first principles physics to measure the glacier system. We're using light and sound and gravity to try and understand its structure, and by understanding its structure, make better predictions about its future. My particular role in this project is focused on using ice-penetrating radar, which sends pulses of light into the subsurface to measure both the geometry and electrical properties of the glacier itself. That helps us figure out kind of how it's flowing now, how strong the substrate is that holds the ice back from flowing out into the ocean, and it also gives us some information about kind of the strength of the ice itself.
So each of these 2 radars, the whole long sled and the small antenna, send out an electromagnetic pulse that travels through the ice, reflects off of material boundaries, and comes back up, and allows us to map out snow and ice thickness, the structure of the glacier, and the dynamics of the glacier in real time.
While data collection has to happen in Antarctica, the exploration happens after we have the data. The interesting frontiers that we're pushing are happening here on campus with the data and the science that I can do with my students.